Okay, it's a shark incoming.
There you are, Trevor.
Ah, but ain't my favorite marksman, huh? How are you, Cletus?
Fine and dandy, sir. You ready to hunt some elk?
Beat satellite dishes. Lead the way.
Oh, here you go. Now, put this in your mouth. A bad day hunting still beats a good day working, my pa always used to say.
Oh, what he gave us? And at this point, I'm too afraid to ask.
What is this thing in my mouth? And why do I have the feeling I'm not the first person to use it?
I'll explain that in a while. Let's start with the basics for now. Elk senses are razor sharp. If they see you or hear you, you'll spook them, and they'll bolt. You gotta move slowly and quietly and keep that aside. But an elk's nose is as big as defense. When you're tracking elk, you always need to watch the wind direction. If you don't stay downwind of them, they'll pick up your scent and be gone before you can say boo, especially with that distinctive, musk of yours.
I'm calling pot and kettle on that, my friend.
All right, this is a prime area right here. You feeling ready, Trevor?
Raring to go.
Okay, let's see if we can bag ourselves some elk. I saw a young bull using a down tree to scratch his antlers on not 10 minutes ago. Follow me. I'll keep us downwind so we don't spook him. Go on, put him down. Can't get too much cleaner than that. All right, stick with me. I'll lead us further in. Keep quiet and stay close. I ain't seen much else or nothing else out here. But we're gonna have to see if we can coax one into the open. That's where that thing you've been chewing on comes in.
Ah, yes. Please enlighten me. It tastes like old person.
That's a diaphragm. Mm-hmm. An elk whistle to you and me. All right, give it a good blow. See if we can get any nearby elk to holler back.
Sounds like someone strangling a clarinet player, and I talk from experience.
Shh, listen. Okay, you hear that? He's over there. You're downwind, so he's yours to lose, Trevor. Go get him. You got him. Pull the trigger. That's a good distance there. Heart shot, like a true professional. Okay, follow me. We'll move a little further in. Stay quiet. I think we might have a mating pair up ahead. Let's check it out. Now, remember, if it's a pair, we're only here for the male. No does. That's my rule. So if you see one with no antlers, leave it be. Blow your whistle again. See if you can get a beat on him. Okay, this is good. Same as before, nice and steady. Give the whistle another blow. Now lay him in the shade. You got this now, Trevor. You're on your own for the next one. Tell you what, I got an idea how we can go in on this together. Text me a pic of your next kill, and we'll talk business. Ah, I gotta go. Good luck. I'll holler at you in a while.
Yeah, not entirely enjoying the hunting. But at least we're done with these.
Got the photo. Another nice kill. So this is what I'm thinking. All this demand for wild-raised meat with them city folks right now? If we divide and conquer, I reckon we could make ourselves a tidy little sideline. Text me a photo of your quarry. I'll let you know what it's worth and come by to pick it up soon as I can. I like my meat with some age on it anyways. What do you say?
Yeah, I say we'll see. I got a few other irons in the fire at the moment.
All right, well, the offer's there. And you can keep that elk collar. Was my grandma's before she passed. Be hearing from you.
Yeah. Anyways, I'm gonna resume recording when I, like, begin some other stuff. I don't know if I will be doing side activities. Who knows? Okay, the fuck?
From that case! Now, you are a dead man!
Yeah, I don't care too much. That was a random thing, so I decided might as well take it. So yeah, I'm gonna do some hunting, but probably it won't be too fun, so yeah, I'm gonna pause the recording for now. Alright, it's a goddamn time to move up with the main storyline. At least I hope this will be a storyline mission, not like a cutscene.
Get back here! You're not even hidden! Have you got it?
I've been trying, Trevor. I've been trying.
Come on over here, alright? I ain't gonna hit you.
I've been trying!
I know.
I thought you said you weren't gonna hit me.
I thought you said you were gonna find fucking Michael Townley.
There's two Michael Townleys living in L.S. One is 83, and the other one is at kindergarten. I asked the teacher to put him on the phone just to be safe, but she threatened to call the cops. I ain't no molester, Trevor.
Shut up before I molest you, all right? Now, is there anything else?
I look through the phone directory. I did find a Michael DeSanta, about the right age, married with two kids.
What's his wife's name?
Amanda.
Amanda?
Yeah.
You're a genius, you moron. Come on, come here.
Woo!
Don't you ever not tell me things I want to know!
Sorry, Trevor.
Run, you little bastard! Get out here! We're going to Los Santos!
Are we?
Not you, me and Wade.
What about me?
You're CEO of Trevor Phillips Enterprises. Find us some business so that we can make some money. And tidy my shit up. Let's go, Wade, come on. I'm driving. You can jerk me off if I get bored. I'm joking. You can suck me off.
Are we gonna stop for ice cream?
Yeah, Trevor.
So we're heading to Los Santos then?
Soon.
Wait.
I gotta make a stop.
Why?
Oh,
what's
the stop? Ice cream?
No, I don't know. Why not?
Where are your people at in Los Santos?
It's just my cousin there, Floyd. He's bunked in with his girlfriend someplace called Vespucci Beach. So what's the stop?
Family's important, Wade. Not as important as the man that's employed you, mentored you, and fed you amphetamines this last year, but it's important. We gotta pay this cousin a visit.
I ain't seen him in a while, Trevor.
All the more reason to drop by.
Okay, That might be nice, but where are we stopping on the way? Because, you know, I'm getting kind of wet over here.
For fuck's sakes! Another chapter of the Lost have descended on this fine town, looking to mourn and maybe revenge their dead. I was thinking me and you could pay our respects.
Trevor, I don't think we'd be welcome there. I mean, wouldn't you want to, well, send them on their way to begin with?
Grief has a beautiful way of bringing folk together, Wade. Just you wait. And besides, I brought them gifts. Lost camp. Ooh, I got some fond memories of this place.
Yeah, I must say, I tried like 3 times to the air mission, and I rage quit after the 3rd one because I flew over prison, and it's like a little bit from the detected you. So it's like, oh, god damn it. So it was enough.
The asshole's here. They slipped. Ice took a hold of this whole place.
You're lost. You are not forgotten, brothers. We'll find that motherfucker.
I got you them bombs and that pistol with the thing that makes it quiet on it.
Yeah, I took them. Those are my gifts for these pricks. Sit tight, little buddy.
I'll try not to get killed.
Thank you.
and let's get out of town. Los freaking Santos.
Can I go okay? I heard like a banging and screaming, but then not the nice kind.
Yeah, it went good, Wade. We don't have to think about the loss no more. Let's go find my old buddy.
This Michael Townley guy must have pissed you off real bad for you to want to find him so much.
He didn't piss me off. The guys that killed him? The federal government. They pissed me off.
But if he's dead, who's this?
Now you're starting to grasp the pertinent questions. Who is this guy using my dead friend's tired-ass movie quotes? With my dead friend's alias? And my dead friend's family? In a house that must have been paid for with my dead friend's stashed millions?
Wow, that's a real mindfuck.
Yeah, I'll show you a fucking mindfuck. I'm gonna stick my boy in your eye. It's gonna come out of your ear, huh?
I didn't mean anything by that, T. Trevor!
Lube up your eye hole, fucker! Because I'm gonna fuck your tiny mind, huh? I'm about ready to turn you into roadkill!
Please, don't turn me into anything! I just want to be Wade. Are we nearly there yet?
No, Wade.
Are we nearly there?
You keep this up, you're not gonna get there at all.
Can you tell me a story?
No, Wade.
Let's play a game then. You know animal, mineral, or vegetable? I'll go first. I'm nanotechnology.
You're what?
Ooh, damn it. I gave it away. I wasn't supposed to say what I am. I'll start again. Animal, vegetable, or mineral?
Hey, how about this? I'll tell you a story if you promise never to speak again.
I like stories.
Of course you do. This story's about a boy called Trisha.
Gee!
You didn't see my car? A boy called Trisha.
Is Trisha a boy's name?
It doesn't matter.
Sounds weird.
He was weird. He was the smartest, toughest, weirdest kid in Canada. Well, in the Canadian border region of America.
Okay.
This boy, he had all the talent, charisma, and guile that a boy could have, but he didn't know what to do with it.
He should become a baseball player.
No, he shouldn't. Because he's not a fucking sellout idiot.
Or hockey player.
That's it. That giant sprawl, Los Santos.
Oh, this is it. This is it. So, this is Los Santos.
I guess it is.
I always wanted to come here.
But you got stuck in the desert?
It's still San Andreas.
Best part of the state. So, Michael, this is where dead men come back to life. It's been nearly 10 years, but you'll keep for another day or so, huh, old friend? You motherfucking fuck! I grieved for you! You weren't even fucking dead. You were my best friend. Well, guess who's coming to shit on your doorstep, you fuck!
Lloyd ain't around here. What are you doing?
Los Santos, the city of shitheads. Where else would he be?
It's Vespucci Beach where he's staying. Will you tell me the story about that boy, Trisha?
Ah, yeah. Where were we?
Right. So, this kid, he could fly planes. So, he signed up for the Air Force to fly all day long and bomb villages and maybe, just maybe, drop the nuke. And it was all going well until one day, just before he got his wings, an evil witch in charge of psychological evaluations told him he was unstable and grounded him for life.
That's terrible.
It was. Sent him into a deep pit of doubt. Despair. And just then, just as he hit rock bottom, he met a fat,
silver-tongued troll under a bridge.
That's cool. What was the troll's name?
Mike. Michelle.
A lady troll?
Yeah, he had tits, like one, but no, he was a boy.
Michelle is a funny name for a boy.
Well, this was a funny boy. He sat under his bridge, robbing anyone who passed him by. Sometimes, he'd go into town and rob the shops and inns and such. And he persuaded our hero that maybe he should rob people too. And you know what? Little Trisha did rob people. And little Trisha was good at it.
And they lived happily ever after?
For a while. Until the troll met another troll in a strip club. And they fell in lust. And he bought her a pair of fake troll tits. Even bigger than his real troll tits. So she could make more money stripping. Maybe a little on the side without call work, but you didn't hear that from me. Wow. And then she pushed out a pair of little trolls, and the big bad troll under the bridge went soft.
Hold on, what?
So little Trevor made a new friend called Brad, and he was thinking about cutting Mike off.
Oh, we're near Floyd's house. I've seen it on iPhone maps. I'll give you directions. Just straight over this one.
We know what happened with Trevor. What's their backstory?
This is the place! I think it is, at least.
What's good?
Cousin Floyd! Come up here, Trevor! Floyd, it's me, Wade!
Who?
Me, Wade, your cousin!
Who?
Your cousin! Fuck! He's come to visit you, you rude fuck. Now get up off the floor and fix me a fucking drink.
Oh, you wait. I heard you was off smoking meth somewhere.
No, not somewhere. Here, he's gonna smoke meth here. Give me a fucking lighter.
You can't smoke here.
Okay.
This is my girlfriend's place. She's at a business conference. You can't smoke here and you can't stay here.
How's it going, cousin? It's been a while.
Yeah, I ain't seen you since you was caught in Evelyn's bed.
A guy was never proved.
You gotta go, both of you. My girlfriend, she'd kill me if she knew I had guests.
Well, it's not much of a girlfriend if she don't like your family. Now, would you get me a fucking drink? I'm not gonna ask you again.
Oh, yeah, okay. Wait, I ain't got no booze.
Well, then you go out and fucking get me something. You go, too.
All right, okay.
Fuck.
I'm gonna pause the recording for now. And figure out what the fuck I actually want to do. Oh, there are some businesses I can buy. Actually, I'm more inclined to just give... see what we can buy with Michael and Franklin and then deal with him. The fuck is this? Oh, Rampage. Okay. Yeah, we have some shit to do, I guess. So yeah, I'm gonna resume recording soon.